In 1981, incidents of a mysterious illness began to emerge. According to the Morbidity and Mortality Weekly Report, 5 men died within months after their symptoms began. The original report did not mention the race of the men. However, later it was acknowledged that there were actually 7, 5 white men, 1 Haitian man, and 1 gay African-American man. The following 4 years would see death counts rise to epidemic levels with no leadership or even acknowledgement from the President of the United States, Ronald Reagan. Today is HIV Long Term Survivors Day, a day we recognize and bring awareness to the issues and struggles of people living with HIV for more than 10 years, some as many as 40 years. This is also a day of celebration. It is a day that we here at Thrive Support Services and the Silver Lining Project celebrate the lives, the struggles, and the victories with honor. Although the struggles of Black men, women, and people of trans experience have been hard over the years, we thank the scientists, the doctors, and yes, the pharmaceutical companies who have changed our lives over the last 39 years. We applaud our long-term survivors for their perseverance, faith, and hopefulness. This is a campaign to celebrate people not just living, but thriving with HIV. This is Long Thriving Survivors Day. Hold on. Against the historical timeline of HIV in Black America, six Black men living with HIV tell their stories of struggle with medication, compliance, and pill management of near impossible drug regimens. They express their gratitude for the one pill regimens of today. Listen as Nathan, Carrie, Jamel, Kevin, Joe, and DC tell their stories of struggle and triumph.
I was diagnosed in 1984. I vividly remember all of the controversy and stigma around the only available med at the time, called AZT. People were on this regimen, experienced so many side effects, largely due to the amount of AZT prescribed and how it had to be taken every 4 hours around the clock. Side effects were darkened skin color and the drastic change in hair texture from kinky to straight. Fortunately, or unfortunately as it may be, meds were not administered until an individual CD4 count was under 350. So I did not have to take medication until after AZT was prescribed. The specific side effect I experienced was when I was on DDI, which really caused extreme gastric intestinal issues. It became almost intolerable and very belabored trying to navigate the daily activities of your day, not knowing if you would make it to a bathroom in time. Nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea became normal occurrences, which I tried so hard to hide for fear of being outed. Living with the side effects was hard, but not being able to talk about it was even worse. Through the years, I've been on so many regimens, one called Zeret, which has left me with neuropathy in both of my feet, and many which have resulted in my ongoing sensitive gastric issues.
Diagnosed HIV positive December 1987. I was prescribed a cocktail of AZT and Zeret. It seemed apparent that my doctor was learning of the disease like I was, and I approached my treatment with great skepticism. The regimen at that time was difficult to comply with due to my working a full-time job, and the regimen itself required taking 3 pills 3 times a day with food. I would often forget to take my medicines. I became completely noncompliant for about 13 years, falsely believing that my faith in God was the answer. In 2000, I was diagnosed with shingles, which was extremely painful and tormented me 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, from April to June of 2000. After the shingles, I was eager for treatment as my T-cell count had dropped significantly to below 300, and I was officially diagnosed with AIDS.
Thank you. When I was diagnosed with HIV in March of 1988, I was prescribed AZT. This was the only hopeful drug available to sustain life. Unfortunately, AZT did not work for many people. I remember having to take up to 19 pills a day just to stay alive. I hear people talk about pill burden today. They have no clue what pill burden is. I believe I have taken over half of the HIV medications that are on the market today.
When I was a kid, I took liquid Norvir. The medication change was a solution to lower my pill intake from 30 pills a day. The doctor suggested mixing the medication with chocolate milk or pudding to eradicate the taste. All it did was take a childhood favorite and turn it into a burning, toxic mix. Liquid Norvir was so disgusting, I decided I wasn't going to take it anymore. So, I devised a plan. During medication time, I'd distract my mother and pour the meds out on the floor and quickly swallow the milk. It didn't take long for the liquid medication to burn a hole in my mother's carpet. Once she noticed it, we were off to the doctor's to get my meds changed immediately.
When I was first diagnosed HIV positive in 2001, my doctor said I had 4 T cells and 6 months to live. I was immediately placed on antiretroviral medications. I knew I wanted to survive, but pill management was something I had to learn to adhere to. This task wasn't easy, as I had to take up to 16 pills per day. At the time, while the quantity was somewhat overwhelming, one of the medications was the absolute thorn in my side. Twice a day, my regimen included swallowing 8 pills of Oprenivir, also known as Agenerase. I referred to these as jelly beans on steroids because the size of the pill was humongous. I used to sit and cry every time I took these pills, as the size of the pills were a huge struggle to swallow, and the thought of doing this twice every day for the rest of my life was horrific. My partner at the time would sit across from me and watch as tears streamed down my face. Every time I finished the regimen, he would hug me without saying anything.
Now, one strong pill that gives you colorful dreams, Atripula. I'll have to take this for the rest of my life. So I thought. And then you think, oh my God, how can I remember to take this pill? How will I live? The good news is, it's not a death sentence like it was in the 80s when people were dying a few weeks after being diagnosed from the meds they were taking, that AZT. It's a new time now, and 16 years later, I'm taking one pill a day without colorful dreams. I'm living, I'm thriving. And at 57 years old, I'm looking pretty good. And I'm thanking God each day.
allows individuals, myself included, to be compliant with taking my meds as pharmaceutical companies have developed a single pill to include up to three separate medications in one capsule.
Twenty years later, I take two pills a day to sustain my life. After three decades of living with HIV, I finally feel confident in my ability to take my medications consistently and without issues. The number of pills in a regimen today is truly a medical miracle.
Today, it is a big relief to only have to take one HIV medication a day to maintain my life. Today, I'm in the best health, even when it comes to HIV, than I was during the early 90s.
As new medicines were introduced by the FDA, my doctor then prescribed different medications over numerous years to get me to undetectable. These medicines were Atripla, Truvada, and now Biktarvy. I remain compliant from June 2000 until present, and I'm grateful to be one of the long thriving survivors. I applaud the FDA and many infectious disease doctors and epidemiologists for the progress in treatment. Although there is no vaccine, I can say I'm still here because of the medications. I'm still here to see my grandchildren become adults and long for a bright future because of medications.
Still, as much as I have experienced, as they were developing more tolerable and more effective meds, I'm forever grateful that my pill burden has gone from 14 pills per day to just two. More importantly, I'm grateful that I'm still here.
Thrive SS and the Silver Lining Project express our sincere gratitude to the medical community, to the scientific community, to the pharmaceutical community, all of you who have worked on these HIV antiretroviral medications and made pill management and compliance easy. We do appreciate it. We know you're going through a hard time right now with COVID-19. Hang in there. But also we'll remind you, we still need a vaccine as well. Thanks very much for everything you've done. Have a great, long, thriving Survivors Day.